Hi there, Stacy here. Have you heard of mind mapping but never quite understood what it was or how it can help you? Mind mapping is a technique that allows you to use visual diagrams to communicate ideas like this. In this video, you will learn how to use this tool for writing assignments, note-taking, and studying. So let's start by looking at mind mapping as a writing tool. Some of my friends find writing frustrating because they have great ideas, but when they write them down, they lose their train of thought. So sometimes the ideas aren't presented in a sequence that makes sense to the reader. My problem was that I would write one sentence and not know what to do after. I would get comments like this: "Good start, but you need to develop your idea a bit more." It was so frustrating. Now the first thing I do when the instructor gives me a written assignment is to brainstorm using mind mapping software. At this stage, I just focus on getting my ideas out. A lot of mind mapping software will have a function that will allow you to create thought bubbles for each idea. Then, once all my ideas are represented, I'm able to move them around. If you have trouble with the flow of writing, this will allow you to work with the ideas until their order makes sense. Finally, you can add arrows to your diagram to show the connections. You can even add little notes to each bubble, which can be hidden to add extra details. Depending on my mind map, I might add key terms I want to use or authors I want to refer to. You can write the assignment using the mind map directly or transform it into an outline first. The more advanced software programs can do this quickly. Also, don't forget to watch our writing video to learn what other tools you can combine with mind mapping in order to make writing a much easier process. But mind mapping is not only useful for writing assignments. You can use it for note-taking, especially since it's a great way to show the relationship between the ideas. You can do this by using mind mapping software or other tools we discuss in our note-taking video. Since mind mapping is such a versatile tool, choose a software program that offers templates. These templates are well identified and cover a lot of different tasks, including preparing lab reports, presentations, and even websites. And how can you use mind mapping for studying? Easy. Making mind maps out of textbook chapters can be a great way of starting the studying process. This allows you to understand how one concept relates to the other concept. So, when it's time to write your exam, you'll be ready for any type of question. First, I use the bubbles to identify the keywords in my chapters, and then I use the note function to record definitions, related ideas, or even memorization tricks. Then I continue my mind map by identifying examples, case studies, and subcategories. I add arrows to show how they all relate to each other. Just doing the mind map itself is a good way of preparing for your test. But I really like to personalize my mind map by adding images that will help me remember difficult terms and other facts. Finally, I like to test myself by hiding parts of the map and seeing what I can remember. Wow, that was a lot of information, but don't worry about remembering everything. The great thing about mind mapping is that it's so versatile. You can adapt it to fit the way you learn best. For more ideas about how mind maps can help you study, check out the support services available at your campus and visit our website for other videos and resources.